Welcome. We'll start with the Kurukshetra January edition. Now, this has been a special issue and focusing on women empowerment. This is important not only for your general GS papers, but also for your essay writing paper. So you can have lots of ideas, lots of case studies from here, which you can help your answers with in essay writing. Now, the first thing that we would start is the first article that talks about empowering the rural women and what are the ways forward for it. So there have been convergence of various social, economic and political issues that we have been talking about, and the idea is to bring out various schemes for the development. Now there have been various certificate distribution, 50% of those has been mainly in the name of Kaushal Vikas Yojana to the women. So of the 100%, 50% went to the women and 50% to the men. So there was a huge proportion that was distributed to females. The next was, what are the areas in which we need to work for? Healthcare, nutrition. So in nutrition, you would have the Suposhan scheme. You have the Mission Indradhanush, where you talk about immunization of the child. Issues related to property, domestic violence, education and literacy. Then you have access to technology, skill development. So you have Skill India, Digital India, Make in India that we would talk about. The vulnerabilities to climate change and the various schemes that we would be discussing today. Now, if we talk on to this ratio of the work participation in the rural and the urban areas, now this woman participation in the rural area is around 30% as compared to urban area, which is around 15.4%. So a lot of females are working in the rural areas. Now the proportion of females who are working in the rural areas are mainly focusing on the agricultural section and not on to the non-agricultural section. The non-agricultural section is predominantly occupied by the male working population. Around 80% of the families have head of the families as females, and but when it comes to the operational land holding, it's only about 12.78%. So these are some of the facts that you need to know and remember. Coming on to the government efforts, the first is the Deen-Dayal, Upadhyay, Antyodaya Yojana. Now this, under this you have the Ajivika scheme, that is a product of the Ministry of Rural Development, and the idea is to bring one woman from each rural family under the self-help groups. So one female would be there under the self-help group from each of the families. Under Deen-Dayal, Upadhyay, Grameen Kaushal Yojana, we talk about the rural skill, the rural youth, and providing them jobs. Of the total jobs, one third of the jobs will go to the females. So that's again one of the important schemes. Mahila Kisan Sashaktikaran Pariyojana, strengthening women's hold into the agriculture. Then we talk about Ministry of Women and Child Development. They have launched various programs, of which the important idea is to empower the elected women representatives. So the females who become the sarpanch have been given special training and how to go around with the issues for the females and the children. The next is Rashtriya Mahila Kosh, very important. Now this is important for your objective questions. It's a basically a microcredit facility that has been given to the females who are working in the informal sector, and this has been given without any collaterals. That means you don't have to produce any deposits to get this credit facility, and this is a kind of small credit that is available to the females so that they can start up their small projects. The next is STEP. STEP, the full form is important. It's support to training and employment opportunities for females. It's mainly for the benefit of women in the age group of 16 and above years for entrepreneurship. Next is Mahila Shakti Kendra. That's a sub-screen of the major scheme, which is Mission for Protection and Empowerment of Females. Now under this, you have four basic ideas that are discussed. It talks about development of skills, employment, digital literacy, and finally health and nutrition. The next is Rajiv Gandhi National Crèche Scheme for Children of Working Mothers. Now under this scheme, the idea is every company which has more than 50 employees should have a crèche facility, and that would be provided to children up to age of 6 years. The next is SheBox Online Complaint Management System for Working Women. That's again has been implemented under the Act of Workplace Act 2013. So it's important. The community engagement through college students has been another effort. Then very important is NARI. That's National Repository of Information for Women, and it provides citizens about the various government schemes that have come up so the women can get benefit of those schemes. So NARI is a very important scheme. The next is One Stop Centers. Now this is for women in crisis, so they can directly reach through video conferencing, get shelter, get assistance, medical assistance and so on. Now, we have also been focusing on the priority areas. Those are the rural areas, hilly terrains. You have Jammu and Kashmir region, you have the west left wing extremist regions and so on. Now, when it comes to economic empowerment, Mission Purna Shakti is very, very important. Under Mission Purna Shakti, it's a kind of single window system for all women programs that are run by various ministries. It has digital base for e-learning. Then you have one of the movie that was released in the name of Gulab Gang, and it was basically how women protest against the social injustice that occurs. If we talk on to the contribution, the female contribution is much higher than the males when it comes to agriculture in the rural sector, where nearly 86% of the workforce is females. The females are employed 86% and 74% of the males are employed. When it comes to manufacturing in rural areas, again the proportion of females is higher than males. So rural India is definitely a hub for employment of women. Then there are two major things that we need to focus on. First is the less amount of wages that are given and the working hours. So those two are the key concerns that we need to talk about. And there has been a kind of daily wage disparity that accounts for 75%, that was around 75% in 2004 and 5, and that increased to nearly 80% in 2013-14. So that was a huge amount. Then we also talk about free and compulsory education under the name of Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan that you are already familiar with. We talk about the female literacy. Now female literacy is very less as compared to male literacy. So male literacy stands at around 80% and female literacy at only around 65.4%. So we definitely need to bring this female literacy up. Then you have the people who have completed formal education up to the level of graduation in the rural areas are very less. It's only 4.5% males and 2.2% females. Some of the important issues that we need to focus on is getting primary education, removing or decreasing the child marriage and child mortality by 16% and maternal deaths by 23%. So some of the focus areas are education will empower the women, education will promote more tolerance, it will bring equality and improve job opportunities. So these are some of the issues that we need to focus on. Coming on to the constitutional provisions, there are numerous constitutional provisions that are mentioned here. Now this is important because you can support your answer with these facts. So Article 14, equal rights for men and women. Article 15(1) prohibits any kind of discrimination. Article 16, we talk about equal opportunity for both males and females. Under Article 39(d), we talk about equal pay for equal work, so equal remuneration for males and men and women. Article 42, providing humane conditions for work, that's very, very important. Now, besides these articles, there are numerous acts that have been passed. Hindu Succession Acts talk about that women have the right to parental property. Dowry Prohibition Act came in 1961 that declared dowry as illegal. Equal Remuneration Act that talk about equal wages for men and women. MTP Act 1971. Then you have Criminal Law Amendment Act 1983. Then you have the Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act that was finally given in 2005. Coming on to a very important aspect, that is National Policy for Women 2016. Now this National Policy of Women is very, very important. Seven priority areas have been laid down. A direct question can be, which of the following is not a priority area under National Policy for Women? So here are the seven priority areas. So you must go through these and remember these carefully. Those would be available in the handouts at Examrace, so just refer that. Coming on to the next scheme is Ujjwala Yojana. Under Ujjwala Yojana, we say till now the rural females were using gas chulas, and these gas chulas were basically creating smoke problems, and the smoke that is ingested is much, much dangerous than a kind of cigarette that is being smoked. So for 400 cigarettes, if smoked in an hour, equals to the amount of pollution that is being caused by the traditional chulas. So bringing LPG to each and every household was very, very important. And under the Sustainable Development Goal 7, we talk about sustainable energy services by 2030. So LPG is a kind of effort that has been reached the villages of India. It is much advanced, much cleaner source of fuel. 40% of the population is deprived of the cleaner fuel, and our aim is nearly 80 million people get LPG connection by 2020. So that's what we aim to achieve. This project was initially launched in Balia in Uttar Pradesh. The subsidy so far was given to each and everyone who were availing LPG. Then the government asked for voluntarily giving off of the subsidy. And finally, the subsidy that the people now get is directly into the bank account. So any kind of corruption in between or red tapism has been stopped. So that's a kind of very important move. Then we already talked about Give It Up. Under Give It Up subsidy, there have been nearly 13 million people who have released the subsidy for the benefit of the poor. Now, maximum connection so far has been given in the areas of Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. The next is the idea of LPG Panchayat. Now, what are LPG Panchayat? LPG Panchayats are the panchayats that aim to create awareness about the importance of LPG connections. You have the National Mission on Clean Cooking. Now, this national mission aims to provide clean cooking, efficient cooking by 2022. So, all research and development for this would be led, and the idea would be more efficient cooking and more cleaner fuels for healthier lives. When it comes to women's safety, violence against women occurs through five stages. Those five stages are given as pre-birth, infancy, girlhood, adolescence, adulthood, and elderly. You have the women helpline number 181 that has been released, and so far it has assisted 4 lakh females. Then you have panic button and GPS on your mobile handsets. All these we have already discussed in 2 or 3 editions back in the Kurukshetra. So again, it's a kind of repetition. After January 1, 2018, no mobile would come without the idea of the GPS or without GPS tracking. The next is Mahila Police Volunteer. Every Gram Panchayat would have a Mahila Police Volunteer. She would be helping people in the Anganwadis, information collecting, report of missing child, domestic violence, Shishu Rakshak Dal, then visit to Anganwadi once a week, establishing links with the protection officers. And this was first launched in Haryana in the districts of Karnal and Mahendragarh. The next is reservation of 33% for females in police. Then you have the sexual harassment of women at workplace act that has been released in the Vishakha versus state of Rajasthan. Now these cases are very, very important in your constitution. So under GS2, this section becomes very, very important. So Vishakha versus state of Rajasthan case is important. Then you have inclusion of asset victim acts in the asset victims in the Right of Persons with Disability Act. Ujwala, this scheme is different from the Ujala scheme, and this talks about prevention of trafficking and rescue, so rehabilitation and reintegration of the victims. You have the police power line number 1090 that was introduced in Uttar Pradesh. Now under this power line number, the identity is not disclosed. The victim is not called to the police station. Even after the case is closed, till 3 months, there is a kind of regular follow-up that takes place. And along with this, to associate this, you have the Power Angels that has been released. Now this concept is the school going girls are involved for 5 years to create a kind of bridge between the police and the common or the civil people. You have the liberation movement that started in India in 74-75. So far you have various efforts that have been done for removal of parda, sati, dowry, female infanticide, and so on. Now you have the total crimes that are around 11.7% against females, and the rate of crime is around 52%. So that's the statistics that Government of India releases, and we aim to reduce this statistics. As we said, 33% of females is there in the police. Similarly, you have 33% reservation in the Panchayati Raj institutions. So each each village panchayat would have sarpanch, and then in the sarpanch, that was basically the Gram Panchayat, you have the 73rd amendment, and 74th amendment was for the urban areas and 73rd for the rural areas. So it's kind of easy to remember that way. 73rd amendment was brought about with new 11 schedule and 29 subjects that were given. Again, the reservation of women, you have 1/3 of the seats And in 5 states, it has been increased to 50%. And those are Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Himachal Pradesh. So there can be a direct question, in which of the following states the reservation has not been increased to 50% for females or has been increased to 50%. So that's the kind of objective questions that you need to go around. You have a three-tier panchayat system. If the population is less than 20 lakhs, the panchayat system is two-tier. It's for a term of 5 years. You have reservation for SC, ST and females. And government appoints the state finance commission, which is reviewed to understand the financial situation of the panchayats. The next is education of the girl child. Now, when it comes to the education, you have free and compulsory education between 6 to 14 years under Sarvashiksha Abhiyan, which was under the 86th amendment. The literacy has drastically improved from merely 12% during independence to around 74% in 2011. And of this 74% aggregate, you have 65% female literacy. Now, while education for females is important, definitely it provides social development. So that was given under the Kothari recommendations. It provides about gender equality, economic productivity, then you have reduction in infant mortality, improvement in the standards of living, empowerment issues, better future perspectives and inclusive development. Now, what are the major issues? At the primary level, you have low enrollment, you have psychological and sociological barriers. At the secondary level, the dropouts are very high. There are facilities which are not adequate. At the vocational level, there is a stereotyping and domestic preferences that have been set up. So if we talk about progress in the field of education, you have Sakshar Bharat Mission for Female Literacy that targets 80% female literacy at national level. Right to education we already talked about. Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalaya that talks about releasing gender disparities in rural areas. Then you have National Program for Education of Girls at Elementary Level. Rashtri Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan. Madhyamik means middle school. So you aim to achieve education of 75% at secondary level. Dhan Lakshmi scheme, very very important, promote awareness and education of girl child by providing money at birth. Then on the progress and completion of immunization. Finally, enrollment in the school and retention in the school. So retention in the school is very important, and this retention checks out the kind of dropouts from the school. The next is Sabla scheme. This was the Rajiv Gandhi scheme for empowerment of adolescent girls. It's integrated with the National Skill Development Program and has two components, one for nutrition, the other is non-nutrition. Then you have Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. It started in Haryana. And then under this, you have various kind of schemes that have come up. So you have Gudda Guddi boards, you have violence against girls, child marriage, gender stereotyping. What could be done? So there could be three steps. One could be at the grassroots level, that is sensitization and awareness building. Then you have strategic initiatives, that's the target schemes, approach based schemes, legislative initiatives that talks about reservations. Then you have equality. For equality, you have the global gender gap index that was given in 2014. Now this index is given by the World Economic Forum. So which index is given by which body is very very important for your objective questions. So just prepare a list for that. So India ranked 114 from 142 nations, which was far behind. 46% of the children in India are affected by malnutrition, of which 70% are girl child. Then you have exploitation of shram and sharir, so body and labor. Article 1 of the UN Declaration talks about elimination of violence. The idea is to introduce fortified home take ration, that is known as THR, for children of 7 months to 3 years, which has more nutritious value along with the milk proteins that are being given. So you have the Suposhan Abhiyan that has been started, where you have the Poshan Mitra team, Poshan Sanyogini and so on. So this is the Suposhan Abhiyan is very very important. Some of the steps are, in Tamil Nadu you have 25 women food cooperative societies that provide complimentary food to all the 32 districts. You have one whole meal rather than the take home ration for the lactating mothers. Then you have the Indira Gandhi Matritva Sanyog Yojana in Erode and Kudalur district that has been started, and it would benefit nearly 6.5 lakh mothers. Anemia is a major condition in India, and you have 50% males and 70% females which have lack of iron or decreased amount of iron in the body. Now, to curb this, in Nasik you have a scheme that was released that talked about providing weekly supplements of 100 milligrams of elemental iron and 500 mcg of folic acid, 6 monthly deworming and life skill training. Then you have Nari Gaurav Niti. It was released in 2006, focusing on education, quality of life, health and nutrition. Chiranjeevani scheme, which benefited nearly 9.97 lakh pregnant females. Then you have Khilkhila Heart, very, very important. It's an ambulance for safe homecoming of infant and mothers. Then you have Jag Jagi Kendra in the Bihar's non-formal education center, where you sensitize the mothers of a girl child. One stop center scheme we already talked about. In Nagaland, in the Chizhami village, there was a scheme of equal wages for men and women started in 2014. In Rajasthan, you have Rajasthan Samuhik Vivaha Nirman Evam Anudhan Niyam that was released in 2009. Similarly, you have Sakhi Mandals. These Sakhi Mandals provide financial empowerments. Mahila Pashupalak Protsahan Yojana that increased the Doodh Mandali that has been run by the females. So, under the health, there has been a significant drop. So, maternal mortality now stands at 167 in compared to 560 in 1990, under 5 mortality rate at 43 and infant mortality rate at 34, that's below 1 year, that has decreased tremendously from the previous figures in 1990. So, we have definitely worked a lot in the healthcare front, but still, the idea is to control the various diseases. Under it, you have the RM NCH plus A scheme that has been started in 2014. Then you have weekly iron folic acid supplementation program, National Health Mission, elimination of tetanus in 2015 that was attained much before the target that was supposed to be completed in December and it got over in April itself. You have peer education program in the name of Satya, where you have two male and two female that are selected to educate the people. Asha and auxiliary nurse midwives. Mission Parivar Vikas, which focuses on 7 states which have highest fertility rate. Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan scheme. Then you have Janni Suraksha Yojana for safe motherhood. Maternity leave has increased from 12 weeks to 16 weeks. And if the child is about 2 years, then it would confine to 12 weeks only. In all the facilities which have more than 50 employees, you would have a creche facility. Janni Shishu Suraksha Karyakram provides free transport, diet to mother and newborn. Then you have the HIV positive women initiated on a lifelong ART therapy, that's the entry retroviral, so it's kind of viral, so antiviral therapies are given irrespective of the CD4 counts and the WHO's clinical staging. The next is, what are the major issues in the adolescent girls? Some of the issues include mental illness, anemia, then you have problems of depression, higher rates of suicide, you have mental disorders accounting to nearly 75 to 80% that goes unnoticed, and numerous mental and behavioral disorders. So the Global Mental Health Action Plan talks about effective leadership, comprehensive plans, promotion and prevention of mental health and strengthening the system. So here are some of the points that have taken place to curb this. So you are trying to give presentation systems, promote awareness among the people, bring in more people under the idea of education plans, removing any kind of physical barriers, bringing in special educators, distributing more knowledge, having a tweet that is Help Me WCD, that is the Women and the Child Development Center. The next is the folk artists. Now, one of the interesting efforts this time was 200 artists worked for 12 days continuously to renovate the Madhubani railway station with the Madhubani art throughout, covering an area of nearly 9,414 square kilometers. That was a world record in itself. Now, what is Madhubani art? It's basically, it was done by the females of the family to decorate the house, to bring in good wishes from or blessings or good fortune to the family. Now, what happened till 1930, this art was not at all known. In 1934, Bihar witnessed a kind of acute earthquake. And after that earthquake, when you had a British officer, William G. Archer, who visited this area, he found remains of this Madhubani art. And then he started to develop this Madhubani art. Now, how this has been promoted? Through the means of commercialization, skill development, training and digitization of the artwork. If we talk onto the rural front, you have the Minegra scheme where you have 100 days of work to help the development of the region, or you provide employment to the people who are 18 years and up. So it's a kind of bottom-up approach, demand-driven, self-sustaining and people-centered approach. Some of the challenges include malnutrition, poor health, lack of education, unskilled labor, mistreatment and powerlessness. Now some of the tidbits from the whole of the Kurukshetra, some of the major things that have been discussed. First was, the cabinet approved the scheme for capacity building in textile sector. It was basically excluding the spinning and the weaving sections. So that's very, very important. This scheme will have a national skill qualification framework, and 75% of the trained certified trainees would be placed in wage employment under this scheme. It aims to benefit nearly 10 lakh people in 1 lakh traditional sectors. National Nutrition Mission, it aims to supervise and fix targets, map various schemes, introduce convergence of various schemes, provide real-time monitoring, strengthen the Anganwadi systems, set up nutrition resource centers, benefit more than 10 crore people, and this would be given in 3 phases. It aims to reduce stunting, decrease anemia, low birth weight issues and undernutrition and malnutrition problems. Nirbhay Fund was started by Government of India with 22 proposals and an initial corpus of 22,000 crores with 3 schemes, One Stop Center, Women Helpline and Mahila Police Volunteer that we have already discussed about. You have Manushi Chillar, she was the Miss World for 2017. There have been 6 women so far who have been declared Miss World. She is an MBBS student from Sonipat in Haryana. The names of the other are given here. Then you have Saikom Mirabai Chanu. She is the first Indian woman in 2 decades to win gold medal at the World Weightlifting Championship in 2 rounds. First is 109 kg of clean and jerk and 85 kg of snatch. And this 85 kg of snatch broke the Commonwealth World Records. She is the only second Indian after Karnam Maleshwari to win gold. The next is Prime Minister on the Women Empowerment at the Global Entrepreneurship Summit. So the theme was Women First, Prosperity for All. Some of the important females discussed here were Kalpana Chawla and Sunita Williams in space. Then we talked about Rani Lakshmibai, Rani Ahilya Bai for their bravery. In the sports, you have PV Sindhu, Saina Nehwal, Sania Mirza. You have milk cooperatives from Gujarat, Mahila Grah Udyog for Lijjat Papad. Again, the vision for the National Women Policy 2016 aims to provide women full potential in all spheres. You have the Swadhar Grah scheme, that is the scheme for women in difficult situations or circumstances, launched in 2001 and 2002. The next is Nari Shakti Puraskar, that's given by Government of India on 8th March, that's the International Women Day. It was instituted in 1999 to acknowledge females who have done services that lost their contribution for women empowerment. Dr. Ambedkar International Center was dedicated to the nations. The idea was to spread the teachings and the vision of Dr. Ambedkar to and across India. You have Navika's Sagar Parikrama. Now this is the first time from India you have an all-woman team of Indian Navy that would be circumnavigating the globe in INSV Tarini. This is a Make in India sail vessel which is 55 foot long, and this has been skippered by the Lieutenant Commander Vartika Joshi. It was started in September 2017 and it's expected to return in April 2018. So definitely it would make news in 2018, April month. The next is Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandan Yojana. Every third woman in India is undernourished and every second is anemic. So this was started in 2017 to provide cash incentives to pregnant and lactating mothers for the first living birth. The next is Women of India Organic Festival, first released in Delhi, and the idea is to have a kind of annual event every year. Then you have Kala Bongri in Karnataka. The idea is to provide initiative of Kozu or child. So all the baby showers for the pregnant ladies owning toilets and building one toilet for them. The next is the campaign which has nearly constructed 10,000 toilets in 2 weeks. Then you have C-section surgeries. The number has increased in India over the past years, specifically in the states of Tamil Nadu and Telangana. And the idea is the government would prepare a list of all the CGHS, all the private hospitals which are under CGHS to display the data, and then they would pick out the records and what is the reality and what is actually not the reality. So with this we cover the Kurukshetra January edition. This was a special issue, as we said. It's very, very important. Some of the schemes that we have discussed, there could be direct questions on the name of the schemes and the ministry that is involved with that scheme. So stay forward for the Yojana in next few days, and we would be covering the same every month. The handouts would be available at Examrace. Have a very good day ahead.